بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله رب العالمين، اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. وبعد، my dear brothers and sisters, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. وبعد، and my topic for today is about the importance of the cleanliness and the soundness of the heart. As we all know, the deeds that people do in this life could be categorized into two different categories: أعمال الجوارح, the acts of the body or the limbs, and أعمال القلوب, the acts of the heart. Both of them are important, but the acts of the heart are more important than the acts of the body or the acts of the limbs. How did we know that? Listen to those ayat and the hadith from the Quran and the Sunnah of the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام, indicating the very importance of having pure and sound heart, especially in the hereafter. In Surah Al-Shu'ara, for example, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is mentioning the dua that Ibrahim alayhi salatu wa salam made long time ago, where he said, وَلَا تُخْزِنِي يَوْمَ يُبْعَثُونَ. Oh Allah, do not disgrace me in the day in which people are standing in front of you. يَوْمَ لَا يَنْفَعُ مَالٌ وَلَا بَنُونَ. In that day, nothing will benefit people, neither their wealth nor their sons. And then he said, إِلَّا مَنْ أَتَى اللَّهَ بِقَلْبٍ سَلِيمٍ. Except for those came and face Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with a pure and sound heart. إِلَّا مَنْ أَتَى اللَّهَ بِقَلْبٍ سَلِيمٍ. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in an authentic hadith narrated by al-Bukhari and Muslim, he was differentiating between the what is lawful and what is unlawful, and the doubtful matters in between, and what kind of attitude a Muslim, you know, should have whenever he or she is facing some doubtful matters, and that those doubtful matters should be avoided. Where he said, alayhi salatu wasalam, the lawful matters are clear, are plain, and the prohibited matters are plain, and between some doubtful matters. And then actually in the end of the hadith, he said, أَلَا وَإِنَّ فِي الْجَسَدِ مُضْغَةً. Verily, there is a morsel of flesh in the body. إِذَا صَلَحَتْ صَلَحَ الْجَسَدُ كُلُّهُ. If this small piece in the body is pure and sound, then the whole body actually will be the same. وَإِذَا فَسَدَتْ. But if it is diseased, then the whole body actually will be the same. Why? As if the Prophet ﷺ wanted to tell us that the body actually is the manager of the whole body. The heart actually is the director of the whole body. So you better, you know, pay more attention and spend more time and effort to purify your heart, because this is where you have to start from. The purity and the soundness of your heart. Now, what kind of diseases that we need to work on purifying our hearts from? The most important disease that our heart has to be free from, which is ashirku billahi subhanahu wa ta'ala, having partners with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, believing that somebody else could benefit or could harm other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, whether this shirk is the major or even the minor one, which is arriya, the showing off. When you do something, not for the cause of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but to show off. So to be distinct from other people, so everybody will, you know, look at you differently, or, you know, speak high about you because you did this or you did that. This is actually one of the main reasons behind the denial of the deeds in the day of judgment. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was warning us from such a bad disease in our hearts by saying, وَقَدِمْنَا إِلَى مَا عَمِلُوا مِنْ عَمَلٍ فَجَعَلْنَاهُ هَبَاءً مَنْثُورًا. We came to all of what they did in this life, and then we just throw it away. We denied it. We declined all what they did. Because of what? Because of lacking the ikhlas or the sincerity in the heart, and because of showing off or having a riya. Having pure and sound heart is one of the qualities in this life and in the hereafter as well. In this life, every Muslim, male or female, has to make sure that he or she is working hard on purifying his or her heart from any kind of enmity, any kind of enmity, any kind of envy, any kind of hatred, any kind of minor shirk, any kind of riya in this life. Listen to the dua that people made in the Quran, which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala documented and kept it as the Quran to be recited until the day of judgment, when he was actually promoting the muhajirin, the immigrants who came from Mecca to Al-Madinah, and the Medina residents, and even the second generation who came later on. He said subhanahu wa ta'ala regarding those people who came later on, He said, وَالَّذِينَ جَاءُوا مِنْ بَعْدِهِمْ, as for those who came after them, meaning after the first generation. وَالَّذِينَ جَاءُوا مِنْ بَعْدِهِمْ يَقُولُونَ رَبَّنَا اغْفِرْ لَنَا, they say, oh Allah, forgive our sins. رَبَّنَا اغْفِرْ لَنَا وَلِإِخْوَانِنَا الَّذِينَ سَبَقُونَا بِالْإِيمَانِ, oh Allah, forgive our sins and the sins of those who were before us. And then they said, وَلَا تَجْعَلْ فِي قُلُوبِنَا غِلًّا لِلَّذِينَ آمَنُوا, oh Allah, help us leaving or freeing our hearts from any kind of ghil, hatred, enmity, envy toward people. وَلَا تَجْعَلْ فِي قُلُوبِنَا غِلًّا لِلَّذِينَ آمَنُوا رَبَّنَا إِنَّكَ رَؤُوفٌ رَحِيمٌ. One of the bounties that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bestow on the dwellers of the Jannah, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for all of us, for all Muslims to be among those people, is that what he indicated in the Quran. He said, وَنَزَعْنَا مَا فِي صُدُورِهِمْ مِنْ غِلْ, we removed, we took off the hatred from their hearts. And subhanAllah, linguistically, when you say وَنَزَعْنَا versus وَأَزَلْنَا, أَزَالَ, for example, is to remove something. But when you say نَزَعَ, it means that he or she, you know, took more effort. It was harder actually to remove something. نَزَعَ, you know, took it harshly, toughly. It needs more, you know, more effort, more strength actually to remove something from one place to another or to take it off. وَنَزَعْنَا مَا فِي صُدُورِهِمْ, it indicates that as if the hatred is something well enrooted in the hearts of people. So removing and purifying the heart from such a bad quality is not an easy job. It takes time and effort. Having a pure and sound heart is one of the main reasons. One of the main reasons of having an access or easy access to the Jannah in the Day of Judgment. One of the main reasons in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala admits people to Jannah in the hereafter. Listen to this long hadith, and I'm going to try my best to make it short, in which the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam showed clearly that the purity and the soundness of the heart is a main reason behind people to be accepted to Jannah in the Day of Judgment. Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal, in his hadith collection that's called Al-Musnad, narrated the following. Anas ibn Malik radiallahu anhu said that we were in a gathering with the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, and then he said, يَطْلَعُ عَلَيْكُمُ الْآنَ رَجُلٌ مِّنْ أَهْلِ الْجَنَّةِ, a dweller of Al-Jannah, or someone who will be admitted to Jannah, will be showing up now. And someone actually came, a very simple person, very unknown in the community, and he joined the gathering. And the next day before this man came, the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam said the same. He said, يَطْلَعُ عَلَيْكُمُ الْآنَ رَجُلٌ مِّنْ أَهْلِ الْجَنَّةِ, someone from the people of Al-Jannah will be showing up now. And the same person actually came for the second time. In the third day, the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام said the same, يَطْلَعُ عَلَيْكُمُ الْآنَ رَجُلٌ مِّنْ أَهْلِ الْجَنَّةِ, someone from the people of Al-Jannah will be showing up. And for the third day, the same person actually was showing up. So, فَلَمَّا كَانَ الْيَوْمُ الثَّالِثِ قَالَ النَّبِيُّ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ مِثْلَ مَقَالَتِهِ, قال أنس, the narrator of the hadith, commented by saying, وكان عبد الله يحدث أنه بات معه تلك الليالي. Or even before that, one of the Sahaba رضي الله عنهم was Abdullah ibn Amr ibn al-As. He was actually so curious. He wanted to know what kind of good deeds that this person does in order for him to be very special, very distinct in the sight of the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام, to the extent that he gave us glad tidings that this person will be admitted to Jannah. So actually he made up a story that he's in a sort of disagreement with his dad, and then he followed that man and told him that I have a sort of dispute or disagreement with my dad. Can I stay with you for just a few days? He said, yeah, sure, why not? And Abdullah ibn Amr ibn al-As radiallahu anhu, out of his curiosity actually, he wanted to find out why this person actually is different. After staying with him, he said, Abdullah ibn Amr ibn al-As, the one who stayed with that man, he said, قال أنس وكان عبد الله يحدث أنه بات معه تلك الليالي الثلاث فلم يره يقوم من الليل شيئا غير أنه إذا تقلب على فراشه ذكر الله كثيرا. He said that I didn't find out that this person is special in his ibadah. I expected him to, you know, spend the whole night or most of the night praying and crying. This is my expectation. But actually I found out otherwise. He was just a very normal person. He kept sleeping throughout the whole night except for whenever he used to switch from one side to another, from one position to another while sleeping. He used to mention the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and then just he used to wake up for Salat al-Fajr, and that's it. So by the end of the third day, Abdullah ibn Amr ibn al-As said, وَكِدْتُ أَحْتَقِرُ عَمَلَهُ. I was about to belittle what he does or what he did in those 3 days. And then I said, Abdullah ibn Amr ibn al-As, يَا عَبْدَ اللَّهِ إِنِّي لَمْ يَكُنْ بَيْنِي وَبَيْنَ أَبِي غَضَبٌ. And then actually he told him the reality, the truth, that actually there is nothing between me and my dad. Just out of curiosity, I wanted to stay with you and see what kind of deeds you do, to the extent that the Prophet ﷺ gave us glad tidings 3 times, 3 consecutive days, that you are among the people of Al-Jannah. And then he said, that man, he said, مَا هُوَ إِلَّا مَا رَأَيْتَ. There is nothing actually more than what you have realized or observed in those 3 days. قَالَ فَلَمَّا وَلَّيْتُ دَعَانِي. Then just I went away. But he called me back. He said, مَا هُوَ إِلَّا مَا رَأَيْتَ. It is what you have seen, what you have realized. غَيْرَ أَنِّي. And I wanted to pay attention to this. He said, غَيْرَ أَنِّي. Except, أَنِّي لَا أَجِدُ فِي نَفْسِي لِأَحَدٍ مِّنَ الْمُسْلِمِينَ غِشًّا وَلَا أَحْسُدُ أَحَدًا عَلَى خَيْرٍ أَعْطَاهُ اللَّهُ إِيَّهُ. He said, hold a second, it is only what you have seen, but in addition to that, actually, I do not have anything in my heart toward Muslims. I do not envy anybody, I do not hate anyone, I do not have any hatred, any enmity, any envy in my heart toward any Muslims. مَا هُوَ إِلَّا مَا رَأَيْتْ غَيْرَ أَنِّي لَا أَجِدُ فِي نَفْسِي لِأَحَدٍ مِّنَ الْمُسْلِمِينَ غِشًّا وَلَا أَحْسُدُ أَحَدًا عَلَى خَيْرٍ أَعْطَاهُ اللَّهُ إِيَّهُ. And listen to the comment of Abdullah ibn Amr ibn al-As radiallahu anhu. قَالَ Abdullah, هَذِهِ الَّتِي بَلَغَتْ بِكَ. So this is the quality that you are distinct because of it. This is the quality that you obtain. And then he said, وَهِيَ الَّتِي لَا نُطِيق. It is the quality that we could not afford. That's why you are special. That's why you are different, because your heart is very pure. Your heart is very clean from any kind of hatred or enmity, as I said, toward Muslims. So brothers and sisters, the cleanliness of the heart from those diseases, the hatred, the enmity, the envy toward people, and more important than the shirk, having partners with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or even having riya and showing off whenever you do something good, not for the cause of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but to be recognized and admired by other people, is a serious disease. And working on the purification of the heart is not a one-time action, it is a lifetime action. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help us purifying our hearts to be eligible to be admitted to the Jannah and the hereafter. يَوْمَ لَا يَنْفَعُ مَالٌ وَلَا بَنُونَ إِلَّا مَنْ أَتَى اللَّهَ بِقَلْبٍ سَلِيمٍ وَصَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَى مُحَمَّدٍ وَعَلَى آلِهِ وَصَحْبِهِ أَجْمَعِينَ.